Well, we continue along with our next candidate here at the table. Your name and the position you're running for.
Yes, my name is Elsa Wong, and I'm running for Richmond School Trustee.
Okay, Elsa, we ask you the first question we've been asking everybody all day as the first question. Do you live in Richmond, and if so, how long have you lived here?
I live in Richmond for 26 years, and before I came to Canada, I am a professional singer performing across Canada. Over the last 26 years, I have transformed myself from a singer into an entrepreneur a leader in charity and a mentor for over 400 young students.
Okay, so can you, and let's talk a little more about the charity angle, and you obviously are on the front line when it comes to students. Can you talk a bit more about the charity angle and how you're a singer, obviously, and what else you do in terms of the charity work?
Okay, yes, I'm the mentor for over 400 young students because I'm the president of Canada Asia Pacific Business Association. Since 2006, I have taught more than 400 young students, leading them to participate in various volunteer activities and train them to build their resilience and confidence and cultivate the sense of responsibility. That's why I think I have a contribution for the community.
Okay, let's talk about the school board. Can you talk a bit about how you think the school board could do a better job of connecting with the community, with parents, when it comes to bringing new policy in?
Okay, yeah, because I'm a friendly person, and then I can help communicate with some parents. They speak Mandarin and then Cantonese.
Right.
Yeah. So because I as a volunteer for 12 years, I have had the opportunity to be hands-on with many parents. They care about the children's education.
Sure.
And they look for the quality education for benefit for their children. So I can to be a bridge between the parents and also the school board.
Okay.
Yeah, the staff.
And with the few seconds we have remaining, when you have been involved in that kind of experience, do you see that the parents sometimes don't know or need to know more information, but there's just a problem with communication?
Mm-hmm.
Do you see that? Yeah.
Yes. Sometimes because the cultural or because the lack of they can't speak well in English,
sure.
Then that's the problem, create some misunderstanding, or they don't have they don't know what is the policy for. So that's the problem. Yeah.
Okay, well, listen, I thank you for joining us here today.
Thank
and
you.
I wish you luck with the election.
Thank you very
thank
much
you, Elsa.
Thank you.